Welcome back. So now, let's continue and make this path generic. So before that, where is your general store.apk is present? Here, it is under practice.appium framework. But in your code, you are saying that look for general store.apk in source folder. Isn't it? You see that you have given knowledge to this capabilities method until this path only. So you are clearly telling that go to the source directory and in the source directory get the path and find the app, but it's not in the source directory. If I go back to my physical location in my system, it's in the main directory here. Okay, so either you have to change the path from source to Appium framework here, or simply come to your source folder and in that level you can paste it here. It's up to you, but I suggest you to have the apps all under the source level only. Don't write them inside this main, because this is specifically dedicated to for basic utilities like page object files and property files. Okay, something dedicated to that area. You can safely put all your apps under source directory, which is outside of your main directory and test directory. You know, right? All the test goes under test directory and all the utilities, page objects go under main directory and all APKs come under source directory. Maybe this is how you can build your structure. So I have removed it from there, so you can simply refresh the project. Okay, and I think we no more require here. I'll delete it from this location. So it should be here then. Did we find it here somewhere? Let me refresh it again. Appium space framework source. Okay, if I open this, I think I'll see that somewhere. Strange, I cannot see it in my Eclipse. Probably I need to restart, but don't worry. When you run your test, automatically it points to stuff which is present in your local. It will, Java will not look into your Eclipse path. It will look into your physical location. And then when you restart, you will definitely see that. Okay, so for now, you have fixed that issue. Next, you have to get rid of this biggest path from here. So there is a concept called in Java that you can get the current project path dynamically with one method. Let me show you that first. System dot get property. Okay, and the property is user dot dir. So this step will get you the path of your current project. So your current project path is here. Okay, C users Rahul Appium space and Appium framework. So no matter in which machine you run, on that machine, whatever project path they are in, Java will dynamically get the path of the project where this test is running, and it will print if you use this specific method. So now instead of me hard coding my local path, I will simply rely on Java to get the path of my project dynamically, so that tomorrow when it runs in your colleague machine, as you are not hard coding it, it will get the path of his machine dynamically when it is running the test. So after it gets the path until this project level, thereafter you can concatenate with this string. This is not any hard coded thing, right? Source, main, Java, it will be same in every machine. Only path which differs in your machine and in your colleague machine is that base path of your project, like it's in C, users Rahul in me. So if you have a name called Ram in your system, then it will be on C, users Ram Appium framework in your system. So first part of your path will be dynamic and it varies in every machine. So that path you can dynamically get it with your Java method system dot get property. So once you have that dynamically, and then you can use this common. This is a static path and works for every machine. Alright, so we have seen so many things. Why can't we just run our test and see if all the dots, whatever we connected, is working or not? If something fails, we can fix it, isn't it? If I go back to my Word document, I have built a IPM test from my other project, and we have also built a robust plan to define our global properties for Appium desired capabilities. Okay, so we have generalized our emulator app names, right? So we have done till this point. So before we jump into page object design pattern, first let's run our test and confirm if everything is working properly after all these changes, whatever done by us. Fingers crossed. And if it fails also, no need to worry. We will just see the logs, try to understand where exactly things went wrong, and we'll fix it. Okay? You will always fail in the first attempt. Remember that. I may pass or not because I am already working on this from a few years. But when I started first time, I failed 10 times. Somehow I ran into error. Okay? So it's very common to see something wrong. Perfect. This time it worked because I have seen this, creating this from here. So you see that app is in progress. So that means after making all the things generic, we are still able to execute our test cases, which is great. Perfect. It went to this page. So as I said, this test case will actually sum up these two amounts and it will match with this amount. That's the whole test case point here. So it will sum 160.97 plus 120.280.97. It matches here. You can see in the output, sum of the products is 280.97 and the total whatever we got is also 280.97. I put an assertion here to compare the sum of the products and the total value displayed. If these two values do not match, then test will fail. So test here did not fail. That means whatever we have done is correct. So for now, you are not seeing any proper reporting here. Don't worry. We'll be talking about how to see the reports and everything very soon. Alright. So let's convert this whole project into Testng before we bring page object stuff here. Okay, so that we will be completing 1/4 of our project development once we converted that into Testng. Okay, guys, slowly we are getting deeper into our framework concepts. Okay, so unknowingly by end of this section you will learn a lot of things and you will understand the best practices to implement at your workplace. Okay, so till the last lecture we have seen a static development of tests, and now we are trying to fix how industry want to see in framework development. Okay, so converting your test into Testng. So let's remove this public static void main and create test annotation for this. I believe that you have went through my Testng section before watching this framework section. If not, please go and watch that, because I'm not going to again explain the basics of Testng here. So Testng generally uses @test annotation that will be treated as one whole test. So you need not write public static void main and all. Public, you need to wrap whole your test into one method and give the tag called test to that method. That's how Testng works. So total validation, this is our method name, and I am wrapping this whole code in that method. Okay. Right? And for this method, I am giving test annotation, so that testng treats this as whole test and it will execute it. So this test annotation is the heart to run your test cases. It's like public static void main. If you don't write this, then testng will not recognize your method. Move your cursor, but you don't have testng with you. Do you have it? The add testng library, this is a plugin whatever you got from your Eclipse, but you need to add the dependencies in your pom.xml, then only your Maven project recognizes. But here in this case, you can still use the testng without declaring here, because there is a plugin in Eclipse itself. But when you start running this project in Jenkins, there is no concept of Eclipse plugin, and it will fail there complaining that there is no testng. So everything should be sent as part of your code without depending upon any editor plugins. Maybe you will run this project in IntelliJ editor. Okay, Eclipse is not only editor we use, and you can also run this in Android Studio. So that's the reason, make sure you pass things through code instead of depending on plugins. And this is specifically when you start building a framework, not when you practice. When you practice, you can use anything. So when you build your Maven project, by default it will give you JUnit dependencies. As I said in my previous section, JUnit and testng both does the same purpose, but testng have few more features and advantages compared to JUnit. So that's the reason whole industry is now using testng. So let's remove this JUnit, we don't require this, and let's get testng dependencies. Testng dependency for Maven. Somehow I don't like to prefer beta versions because those are not yet stable. So let's put it here. Perfect. So as I said, whenever you write something in your pom.xml, make a habit of building that whole project. Maven. Update your project. You see that? So that it will pull all testng jars into your machine. And once it is done, we are good to go. Nice. Now go back to your test and remove JUnit. So earlier, the assertion whatever we used is on JUnit assertion. And now, as we have removed JUnit, move your cursor on this and say import testng annotation, and the assertion here will be using testng package instead of JUnit. So as we are converting this project into testng, so that assertions also we will use testng only. When I am explaining this lecture earlier, I have used JUnit. So there are still errors here. Let's go and fix them. What happened? Capabilities, add throws declaration. We did already. Oh, we removed all the public static void main, right? So that all this went away. Let's add them again by selecting this add throws declaration. Perfect. So we have converted this particular method into testng, but at the same time, you need to convert this whole framework into testng compatible, not only test. You can simply do that by right clicking your project testng. You will actually get this if you have Eclipse plugin. Okay, so basically this will create you testng XML file. Right click testng and select this convert to testng, so that whole project will be converted to that testng compatible and creates XML for you like this. So I hope you went through this section of understanding the importance of testng.xml in my previous testng section. Okay, sometimes I'm afraid that do people really watch this section before? Okay, if you skip testng section, it's really hard that to correlate now this topic here. Okay, that's why I'm keep on repeating that. Please watch Testng section, Maven section, page object section before you reach here. Okay. Now it created Testng XML for us. Click on next and just say finish, and that's it. You will have an XML file to run your test cases. So instead of running one by one, you can run hold your test cases by passing those links into XML file. Okay, so this one not required dot app test. Instead of this, let's pull few more test cases into this framework. First of all, with one single test, I am experimenting by bringing all the utilities. So once we have some base setup, then I will add one or two more test cases and then run as part of this XML. Okay, and if you have some 100 test cases, just give all the path names here. For now, example, this is the test we are running by just going here, right click, run as Java application. Now I have given the path of this test in my XML file. You clearly see that practice.appiumframework.ecommerce test 4. Okay, so now if I run this XML file, first of all, this XML will look what all test cases defined in my file. It will go to that path and it will execute that test. Okay, so let me run this test here through XML and see how it goes. You see that run as Testng suite. I am not running as a Java application now. I'm running this whole Testng XML file as a Testng suite. Select OK. There are errors in the framework. I know why. We don't require this apptest.java. This got created by default through Maven creation. Earlier we did not see error here because there is JUnit. Now I removed JUnit. This test dummy test is relying on JUnit framework. So cool. And now let me run this test again. Okay, you see that the same test started again. It will again open that e-commerce app, select the products, sum the total and validates with your actual total whatever displaying. So what is the difference between previous run and this run? In the previous run we relied on Java, but now we have carefully converted our test and the whole framework into Testng, and we are running this test through testng.xml file. That's the beauty. So this is how we slowly brought Testng knowledge to this framework. Perfect. So let me go back and make sure that we have done this first 4 points. We have declared global properties for capabilities, make the test Testng compatible to utilize the framework features, and the Maven project generation is done with one sample Appium test. In the next lecture, let's build some page object files. Instead of being hard coding the objects in the test case like what we did till now, let's bring them from page object structure. Okay, instead of having here, and take it from there. All right, thank you.